You're listening to Wednesday Wonders on the Mutual Audio Network. Be amazed.
The following audio drama is rated PG-13, suggesting that children under the age of 13 should listen accompanied with an adult.
Greetings, my loyal passengers. Welcome aboard the Chronosphere. This is your pilot, Daniel French. Today's voyage through the spectral streams will make you witness to events of biblical proportions. Writer Stephen Chisholm has carefully navigated our way through the cosmos for this journey, though I am worried about our return. With that being said, if you still choose to voyage onward, strap in for the Misattunement.
Residence C386, please report to room 14B. Residence C386, room 14B, please.
C386. Corinne, isn't that you?
Yeah.
What do you think they want?
How should I know?
Isn't 14B in the reunification wing?
It is, but I don't know who it could be.
Well, go find out, girl. I'll keep your bunk warm until you get back.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Excuse me. I just need to get by. Let me just squeeze by here and... Hi. Hello. I'm C-386.
C-386? Perfect. You were just called to 14B, right?
Is that...
Oh, yes. Head down the hallway and head up to the second set of stairs to the right. Once you reach the second floor, turn left, and the room you're looking for should be about 6 or 7 doors down on your right.
Thank you.
Well, sure thing. Oh, and, congrats.
Yes. Thank you.
Hey, count your blessings. They're hard to come by nowadays.
You must be C-386, Karine Assar, right?
Yes, that's me.
So nice to meet you. I'm Dr. Mandal. Someone is here to see you. Come on in.
Thank you. I haven't the slightest who it could be. You sure it's me they're here for?
You're the only Karine Assar in our system, including the other 3 facilities in our district. It'd be an awful coincidence if they were looking for someone else of the same name. Here. They're awaiting you in this room over here. Come now. So...
Mom?
Dearest Karine.
Mom? Mom, how are you here? I thought the black hole had taken you. I thought you were in Ghana when it had been swallowed.
Now. Rest easy, my child.
How is this possible?
We've been receiving reports that people are beginning to emerge from the black hole. Not many, but your mother appears to be one of these lucky few.
Oh my God, Mom! This can't be real. This can't be... Mom, you look different. Your eyes seem deeper.
Yes, well... The black hole bears a certain pressure. My sunken eyes may appear unsettling, but it's a small price to pay for enlightenment.
Enlightenment?
Oh, Karin, dearest, I have so much to tell you. To show you.
Show me? Show me what?
Karin, do you mind if I speak to you a moment outside?
I do mind. I thought my mother was lost, but here she is.
I was lost, my child. Just as you are now. But listen to me. Listen to this.
What? What are you saying?
I can't help it. My tongue is sometimes overwhelmed by the melody.
What melody, Mom?
I must insist, Karin. Please, let us talk outside.
Kantalaime, alimulai. Oh, beautiful, isn't it?
Mom?
Karin, please.
Mom, I will be right back, okay?
Of course, dearest, but hurry back. We have much to discuss.
Yes, I will. What has happened to my mother? She doesn't seem herself. And her eyes. What's happened to her eyes?
According to recent reports, those who've emerged from the black hole, the resettlers, are suffering from some sort of delirium. We don't have much to work off as of yet, but all of them seem to suffer from those sunken eyes, like some sort of G-force ocular trauma.
What is it she's talking about? Something about a melody and enlightenment and...
We're calling it the Misattunement. All resettlers, of which we've recently documented a few dozen so far, are reporting some sort of spiritual awakening after being taken by the black hole. Extremely stressful or traumatic experiences often lead to the pursuit of religion or some higher power, but everyone's experiences seem heavily related. We believe the black hole subjects its victims to some sort of pattern, whether visual, auditory, or otherwise, that causes similar hallucinatory experiences. That's the running theory, but there's still much to explore.
Are you saying the black hole has driven my mother mad?
Well, that's putting it a bit bluntly, but the misattunement can certainly be classified as some sort of mental break.
Please, don't tell me she needs to be institutionalized.
No, of course not. Even if we did have the resources to run such programs, it's clear thus far that the resettlers don't present much risk of harm to themselves or others. We will monitor your mother over the next 24 hours, after which time she will be released into the general population.
This all seems so surreal. How can this be possible? Does this mean that everyone who's fallen into the black hole is still alive?
Nothing about any of this is normal. I can't give you any definitive answers. All we can hope is that our remaining physicists somehow discover how to stop its spread, or else we'll all soon know what transpires in that abyss.
Is that still my mother in there?
Of course it is. I'm sorry I suddenly got so glum. Working in the reunification wing isn't quite so glamorous as some would think, so please excuse me for my behavior.
No, it's quite all right. I don't know how to process all this. I'm just... Can I go say goodbye to her before I go back?
Take all the time you need.
And what did she say before you left? Before your goodbye?
She said, it's not a cataclysm as they say. It's emancipation.
What? In relation to the black hole?
I don't know.
You didn't ask?
No, I felt... She seems so much different than I remember.
I'm so sorry, Karin. I don't know what I'd do if my father reappeared, or my sister. I don't know how I'd handle it.
Don't get me wrong, I'm happy she's returned. Ecstatic. But I can't shake this feeling of dread. I've never felt this level of uneasiness. Not even when the black hole first appeared.
They found a way to make the black hole. I'm sure they'll discover a way to make it go away.
I wish I could share in your optimism.
Dearest Karin.
Mom?
This is your mother?
Yes, this is my mother, Wolinum. Mom, I thought they'd be holding you for 24 hours.
They expedited the process, apparently to make room for new arrivals.
More arrivals? Are there more people escaping the black hole?
Oh, Karin, no one's trying to escape the black hole. We're being released as emissaries, you see.
Why don't I let you two have your space?
Mom, what happened to you in there?
I was introduced to the new lord. It's difficult to explain. It'll be better if I show you.
Show me what?
Do you have a car?
No, I don't have a car. Mom, my apartment's gone. My car's gone. Chicago is gone. It's all been claimed by the black hole. Why do you think I'm here?
Is there any way you can get a car? It was a long way here, and I don't know if I have the strength to lead you back by foot.
I hope you're not talking about the black hole. I lost so many friends. We lost so much of our family.
Lost? Dearest Karin, we're all safe and sound. Auntie Fua, Uncle Anum, Cousins Maui, Osei, Iyawi, all we're missing is you. That's why I've come all this way.
Were you prescribed anything? Any neuroleptics?
Excuse me?
For the misattunement, did they give you anything?
Give me a... Karin! There's nothing wrong with me.
Mom, you look exhausted.
As I said, it's been a long journey.
Please rest. You can have my cot.
What? Are you leaving?
I need to see about something. I'll be right back. For now, rest, please. For me. We can continue our discussion when I get back.
Well, okay. But please hurry. I'll have to be returning soon.
Why, Karin? What are you doing back here? I'm sorry, but I'm meeting with someone right now.
Another resettler? Are there really so many that you released my mother without a proper evaluation?
I'm sorry, but we simply don't have the capacity.
She's babbling about taking me with her to the black hole.
Yes, I told you about the misattunement, Karin. There is little we know about it, and even less what to do about it.
I was a nurse, Dr. Mandal. Surely there is something you can prescribe. Seroquel, Tegretol, something.
I appreciate your input, but these patients aren't guinea pigs. Now please return to the auditorium. The reunification wing does not allow for walk-in appointments.
So there's nothing you can do?
No, I'm sorry, Karin, but I must get back to my current appointment. I trust you'll see your own way out.
What? Oh my god!
Karin, you are not allowed in here. Leave now or I'll call security.
What is wrong with that man? Is he...
Karin, outside with me. Right now!
What was going on in there? That man... his head... it was like he was being sucked into a vortex. A wormhole. Is he a resettler? Like my mother?
This is a new phenomenon, I assure you. Otherwise, I would have warned you. This is going to be difficult to hear, Karin.
What? What's going on?
It appears that resettlers are being summoned back to the black hole. You saw how his head was twisting, spiraling backward. Based off initial reports, we theorize that the returners have formed a symbiosis with the black hole. Just as how an atom separated from a molecule becomes unstable, so too are the returners.
How is that man still alive? Still breathing? His head is nearly gone.
There is little we know so far. Everything is conjecture at this point.
Is this going to happen to my mother?
I don't know.
Tell me the truth.
Very likely.
And there's nothing I can do to stop it?
As I said, Karin, we don't have any conclusive evidence. Now please, I need to return to this patient. Maybe if you allow me the time... I can get you the answers you deserve.
Mom? Mom, are you awake?
Oh, Karin, yes, I was just resting my eyes.
You said you wanted to take me somewhere, right? Listen, I just put in a request to take out a car.
Oh, wonderful. Yes, I wish for you to meet the Liberator. He's here to rescue all of us. He's come to deliver us from the God that's forsaken us.
Yes, I'm sure he has. Mom, do you have some sort of compulsion to return to the black hole? A need to?
The Lord loves us so dearly that he can only bear to be separated from us for so long. There is a tether that binds me to him, one that will never allow me to lose my way.
And if you don't return?
That isn't an option, dearest Karin.
Then I'll take you to see him.
That's great. I can see the sadness in your eyes. I shared that once too, but that will soon be gone.
Yes, I'd like that.
Residence C386, your car is ready at Terminal 6. Residence C386, report to Terminal 6.
That's us, Mom.
Off continent. It has been 2 years since the black hole flared to life from the China Jinping Underground Laboratory. Its behavior and appearance utterly baffling the world's leading physicists. Some even refusing to call it a black hole, and instead adopting the term erasure phenomenon. 2 years, and there's still far too little we know about this creeping and mysterious timbrosity, swallowing countries and continents whole. Then, as if the truth of the black hole didn't already seem implausible beyond our comprehension, we were confronted with the resettlers, the long-lost victims of the black hole, given a second chance. That's right. Casualties of the black hole have emerged, as healthy as the day they were taken from us. Hundreds of these people, deemed resettlers by the scientific community, have been documented popping up in the bastion of humanity.
Would you mind turning this off, dearie?
While we celebrate the return of loved ones, some from far-off continents, we can't help but feel the claustrophobia. The black hole has encircled us, leaving us nothing but a fraction of our nation. Is there something we're not...
better?
Much. You can't trust anything those talking heads say. It wasn't China that started all this, and even if it was, the only blame they'd bear was not bringing this blessing upon us sooner.
According to our map, we can arrive at the edge of the black hole by tomorrow night.
Wonderful.
Mom, I'm sorry I wasn't able to get you out of there. Out of Ghana. I'm sorry I wasn't able to get you passage to Chicago or the United States. I should have taken action when the black hole was first reported. I never thought it had come to this, but by the time it was apparent that it wasn't going to stop growing, all travel was suspended. Indefinitely. If I just thought to...
Oh, there's certainly no reason to be sorry, Karin. Oh, I was fearful. Huddled at the beaches of no town with thousands of our own. I was scared half to death. Cote d'Ivoire has shut down its borders, leaving us living out what we thought were our final days, rationing water and crab meat. Watching its approach, the black hole, was beyond description. It was like a cliff of nothingness, creeping towards us, so slow as to be nearly imperceptible.
What was it like inside the black hole? You said you had so much to tell me.
And that I do.
Well?
Remember that church I used to take you to when you were younger?
Of course. The pastor with that awful voice. Luckily, his chorus chanted loud enough to drown out his atrocious singing.
I know once you moved to Chicago, you'd given up on the church, but I continued to go. I continued to open my heart to the teaching of the clergy. I buried my face in the scriptures and lived the life I thought our Creator wanted of me.
Yeah, I know religious groups around the world believe this is the rapture. I didn't believe it before, but seeing you now, here, after you'd fallen into the abyss, I don't know what to think anymore.
No, fear not, dearest Karin. This is not the rapture, at least not in the sense that you've been programmed to believe, though it is a deliverance.
Deliverance? From what? From whom?
For years I worshipped our god, our creator, even through the atrocities he enacted on our kind. Starving children during the coup. Buzzing insects infected with malaria. Reports of child soldiers bleeding into the Gulf. You were young, but even you must remember the Civil War. Hundreds dead.
Yeah, I remember our village was destroyed. Someone in my class was killed.
And all these transgressions, despite desperate pleas to our presumed lord?
Where are you going with this, Mom?
We're being rescued from our neglectful creator. I've met him. Our new god.
Is that so? Maybe you can tell me about him.
He wants to liberate us. Hence his current annexation.
Annexation? You mean the black hole?
He's an empathetic deity. He's told me his ambitions to free all kinds from their malicious creators.
So, this god is the new messiah?
Yes, that's it exactly. He wants to create a world to host the forsaken masses. After all, we didn't ask to be put here. We're prisoners to the whims of an egotistical master.
So you're saying we should be thankful for what's been wrought upon us? This creeping abyss that's devouring our world?
Yes, Karin, yes. You'll understand once you've met him.
Well, I look forward to doing so.
Why have we stopped?
I need a snack. How about you?
Oh, no thanks. I'm only visiting, after all.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'll be right back. How much for these?
$15.
Jesus. Never mind, then. What about your payphone out front? That accept blood donations?
A quarter for 2 minutes.
Well, that I can do. Hello? Yes, hi. This is resident C386. Karina Sare, can you connect me to room 14B? I need to speak to Dr. Mandal. Oh. Well, can you relay a message? Thanks. Can you let her know that she can expect a call from me at 9 o'clock tonight? I have some questions for her. Yes. I understand she may not be available then, but can you please just let her know? Okay. Thank you very much. Yes, bye. How are you holding up, Mom?
Oh, sorry. I'm just resting my eyes. It's exhausting being back here.
That's quite all right, Mom. Lean the seat back. Get some rest. I'll drive for a few more hours and then we can pull over and get some sleep for the night.
Thanks, dearest. I love you.
Love you too, Mom.
Recent reports claim those that have emerged from the black hole, deemed the resettlers, have been hurtling themselves back into the expanding pit. Some of them have even been witnessed recruiting others to join them in their plunge. In a more peculiar turn of events, it appears that the resettlers who've overstayed their welcome, so to speak, have begun to undergo changes in their physical appearance. Some scientists have labeled the phenomenon Misattunement syndrome. Those with this ailment suffer from a disfigurement wherein their bodies appear to be stretching, as if being sucked into an imperceptible wormhole. While they don't appear to be in any pain, the appearance of those suffering from this syndrome can be quite distressing. Early theories suggest that the resettlers have formed some sort of atomic bond with the black hole. While quantum physicists dispute these theories, there has been little else to explain this.
Karin?
I'll be right back, Mom. I'm going to stretch my legs a bit and then I'll return to catch some shut-eye.
Okay. Be safe.
Mm-hmm. Hello? Yes, this is resident C386, Karin Asare. Can you connect me to room 14B? Dr. Mandal is expecting a call from me. Thank you. Oh, Dr. Mandal, are you there? This is Kareen. She's not there. But I told her. She left. What do you mean? She left the facility? Where's she gone? She what? She said she was going to the black hole. She followed a resettler there? What? And no one stopped her? Listen, I'm heading to the black hole myself. Yes, I know, but I saw what was happening to the returners, and I didn't want the same to happen to my mother. Is there anything I should know? Has anyone found a way to stop this? My mother has not yet begun to change, but I'm sure she doesn't have much longer. Well, I'm hoping I'll find some answers when I get back to the black hole. You say it's some link to the black hole that's causing the disfigurement. Perhaps bringing her closer to it will prevent the changes. Oh, what do you know? You're just as lost as the rest of us. Mom! Mom!
Don't be afraid, dear.
Your head! Mom, your forehead is jutting out! It's starting!
My time is running short here. I need to get you through to the other side.
Mom, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do.
Get into the car, Kareen.
Mom, you're scaring me.
Please, just get into the car, dearest Kareen.
Yes, okay, I will. Just hold in there, Mom. I'll do whatever it is you need me to do.
I need you to drive.
What about your rest?
Drive!
Yes, okay, Mom. Just please, calm down.
I'm sorry, dear. It's so difficult being away from him for so long.
Okay then. I'll get you there.
There, why are you crying? We're almost there.
Mom, your condition is getting worse. You're not even recognizable anymore. And I don't just mean your fading appearance, your twisting face, but your personality. Your sudden outbursts. What has this thing done to you?
Thing?
The black hole. Whatever exists beyond it.
I've told you, Kareen. I've told you time after time, again and again and again. Stop resisting.
And if I refuse?
Refuse?
Refuse to follow you. Ah! Mom! Stop!
I'm doing what's best for you. Why can't you see?
I'm scared.
Just keep driving. We've made it. We've made it, Gary. We've made it. Your chance to join us has finally come.
It's so dark. I don't understand how this can be.
Nothing is beyond our Lord's capabilities.
It's nothing like I imagined. This isn't a hole at all. It's just darkness.
And beyond the darkness, you'll discover the light.
Wait, I think I see someone. There's someone over there.
Ignore them and follow me.
Oh my God, it's Dr. Mandal.
Got in.
Doctor, it's me, Kareen. How did you get here so fast? Doctor?
Kareen?
Dr. Mandal, what are you doing here?
I'm tired and lost.
Doctor?
They can't all be wrong, Kareen. They can't all be wrong. It's just not possible.
What do you mean?
I'll see you on the other side.
Doctor! No, wait! Stay right here, Mandal! Stay right... No!
Good!
Mom, how'd you catch up to me so...
I see there's some not so stubborn as you. Now, let's pass through together, dearest Carrie.
I don't... Mom, I don't think I can do this. Ow! Mom! What are you doing?
You've come too far to lose the path now.
Mom, let go!
There's nothing to be scared of.
Mom, please stop. I'm not ready.
I'm curtailing the inevitable, Karin. There's no escaping this.
No, no, no! Stop! Please, Mom, stop! Let go! Ah! Mom? Mom? Can't see anything.
It's okay, Karin. You'll see soon enough.
I can't feel anything.
Here he comes, Karin. Don't be scared.
Mom, what is that? What is that thing? What am I seeing? It's so bright.
The shelter-in-place ordinance is still in effect. Repeat. Until further notice, the shelter-in-place ordinance is still in effect. The returners are now emerging from the pit in indeterminable numbers, and their demeanor is far more violent than their predecessors. We remind everyone to keep doors locked and windows boarded up. If you are to encounter a returner, do all you can to fight them off. While there haven't been any reports or fatal encounters, footage from our air support team has spotted captives being hurled into the black hole. Do not cave to their whims. Do not listen to their pleas. Do not follow them into that darkness. Do not follow them into that darkness.
Mommy, there's someone at the door.
Do not answer it. Do not open the door.
Mommy!
Come here, away from the door.
Please, please, open up. I only wish to introduce you to our Lord and Savior.
The part of Corrine was voice acted by Caitlin Curtis. Dr. Mandel was played by Rosanna Jimeno. Wollinan, Corrine's mother, was voice acted by Anne Greist. Corrine's neighbor and resident of the auditorium was played by Angela Young. Your radio newscaster was Tiana Holly. The security guard in the auditorium was Paul Arbisi. The voice on the intercom in the auditorium was Andrea Richardson. The cashier at the Desert Mini Mart was Rosanna Jimeno. And both the poor mother and daughter alone at home at the end were voice acted by Angela Young. As I land the Chronosphere back in your home dimension, I'd like to thank you for flying Chronosphere fiction through the spectral streams. Please subscribe and share. And until next time, keep your cosmos clean.